Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. We will continue our A1 grammar. Please watch my other videos before if you're not really familiar with German grammar, because I try to make it chronologically, so one topic after another. Judging from my wonderful picture that I draw by myself, took me 20 seconds. Can you guess what the topic will be today? I will tell you in a second. Keep watching. The topic today are verbs, and not any kind of verbs, but verbs that are a big stress factor with German learners. Those are called starke Verben. Starke Verben are strong verbs. So what does it mean? It means you can remember or visualize it like that. They are so strong, they don't accept the common rules of verbs. They change because they want to and they can because they're strong. You know what I mean? I hope you get the picture. Let's read the first sentence. Ich fahre nach München. Fahren, to drive. You don't have to drive yourself to say fahren. It can also mean you go by train or something. So I'm going to Munich. Question, where are you going? Wohin fährst du? So it's quite obvious if you see it like that. The A becomes E. The good news is, with a strong verb, the only change is with you and he, she, it. Ich fahre stays the same, but then it becomes du fährst. Er, sie, es fährt, and then it's normal again. Wir fahren, ihr fahrt, sie fahren. For comparison, we have here a so-called weak verb. Schwach means weak. So, schwach, stark, or you can remember it in its more professional way. Regulär, regularly, irregulär, not regularly. So, as I said, we have a little comparison here. I learn, ich lerne. Du lernst, er, sie, es lernt, wir lernen, ihr lernt, sie lernen. So the whole line stays the same. The rules are quite easy. The only problem is that you have to know what verb is regular and which is not. It's a thing you have to learn by heart or to find tables on the internet. There are many ways, of course, and you need some experience and practice. So A becomes E. This is called an Umlaut. I think you know that. So the first example we already checked, to drive. Next one, schlafen, to sleep. Ich schlafe, du schläfst. Tragen, to hold or to wear, depends on how you use it. Ich trage, du trägst. Waschen, to wash. Ich wasche, du wäschst. Halten, to hold. Ich halte, er hält. Or of course, if you want to keep it with the same line of you do something, du hältst, st at the end. This is the first little group. The second one, the e becomes e. Geben, to give. Ich gebe, du gibst. Helfen, to help. Ich helfe, du hilfst. Sprechen, to speak. Ich spreche, du sprichst. Essen, to eat. Ich esse, du isst. Here it's a little special because the first part is the I. For the only reason, because the first part is here also the E. Nehmen, to take. Ich nehme, du nimmst. Treffen, to meet. Ich treffe, du triffst. Our next category is from E to IE. The combination IE is like a long E, like two E's. You can imagine it like that. Sehen, to see or to watch. Ich sehe, du siehst. Lesen, to read. Ich lese, du liest. This is hard to pronounce. I must be honest, I totally understand, because you have the long E and then the ST sound. I would recommend you to listen to native talkers like me, but also others, and try to imitate them. Our last category is from au to oi. When you listen to me saying it, oi, It's almost like oi, like this sound, like oysters a little bit. Laufen, to walk. Ich laufe, du läufst. Please remember, for your own sake, those words in this combination, because you will need it. There is no other way to learn it. You have to practice it, which we will do in a second. Okay, we will start with this one. You can always go back to check them out, or maybe you write them down. I know I am a little optimistic, maybe too much, but I hope that you try to interact with me now in this exercise. Beispiel, example. Schreibt Peter? Does Peter write? Peter schreibt nicht. Er redet. Peter does not write. He talks. Try to do the other ones and then we will compare. Inge trinkt nicht. Sie isst. Christian lernt nicht. Er schläft. Inge geht nicht. Sie läuft. Klaus arbeitet nicht. Er liest Zeitung. Claudia bleibt nicht. Sie fährt nach Hause. Those examples are really good for practice and also to learn the position of the words. But they are, of course, a little bit short. Second exercise. Beispiel, example. Ich schlafe lange. Nicht lange. They want us to learn how to say the opposite sentence. For example, like here. I sleep long. Carlos does not sleep long. This is what they want you to do. So I do this and he does that, so that you can practice the irregular verb combinations. Okay, give it a try. Don't feel intimidated by the objects. We will correct it in a second. Ich fahre nach München. Carlos fährt nach Bremen. I'm going to Munich. Carlos goes to Brem, I think in English. Next one. Ich spreche langsam. Carlos spricht schnell. I speak slowly. He speaks fast or quickly. Carlos speaks fast. So if you want to say somebody does somehow, you have a nice addition to your patterns. You can say the subject, the verb, and then you have an adjective and you don't even have to change it. Ich lese Zeitung. Carlos liest ein Deutschbuch. I read the newspaper. Carlos reads a German book. If you are wondering why here is no daddy does, no article, but here it is. We will cover this another time, of course. And to get the first impression on how to use it, you can watch my other video about the articles in German. Next one. Ich trage braune Schuhe. Carlos trägt schwarze Schuhe. If you checked out my other videos about fashion, you will see why we have here schwarze instead of schwarz, because it is in front of the noun. So I wear brown shoes, Carlos wears black shoes. Ich esse Kuchen, Carlos isst Obst. I eat cake, Carlos eats fruit. Ich helfe Peter, Carlos hilft Julia. I help Peter, Carlos helps Julia. Ich laufe nicht schnell, Carlos läuft auch nicht schnell. I had to correct it here a little. So, I don't walk fast. Carlos also does not walk fast. Okay, great. We go to the next little topic. It's not that much. We're almost done. Let me get my colors back so we can see immediately what we're talking about here. Schwache Verben, the weak verbs. And again, our strong verbs. And the topic here is verbs that have a T or a D. To be honest, the important part is just that if you have here a T or a D at the stem, you have also to put it in the you, he, she, it, and you plural. You cannot say, I think I told you before, you cannot say du wartst, du redst. It doesn't go like that. It's bad for the tongue. It's painful after a while. So please remember, if a D or a T is involved with the weak verbs, you put the E to make it sound better and easier. With the strong verbs, we have it a little different. As you can see, it is shifting a little bit. So the point of attention becomes front center and it doesn't sound so bad anymore because we have the umlaut or the change in general. So hältst sounds so much better. Then you don't have to say hältest. It sounds easy to pronounce, but it's completely wrong. So please remember, if it's a strong verb with T or D, for you and he, she, it, you don't need to add any E in between. But for the you plural, which is not influenced by the change, A to E, for example, then we need again the E. Does it make sense? Leave it in the comments below if you understood. I'm really happy to see your success. And you will do a little exercise. Beispiel, ich wohne in Passau. Und du? Wohnst du auch in Passau? I live in Passau. And you? Do you also live in Passau? Try to finish the exercise and we will compare it in a second. Ich lese viel. Und du? Liest du auch viel? I read a lot. And you? Do you also read a lot? So this viel after the verb describes how something is done, as I said before. Next one. Ich esse gerne Eis. Und du? Isst du auch gern Eis? As you can see, here is an E and here is not an E. If you Google which way is the right one, it will tell you both is fine. There is no difference. I like to eat ice cream. And you? Do you also like to eat ice cream? Ich schlafe lange. Und du? Schläfst du auch lange? I sleep long. And you? Do you also sleep long? Of course you can make it. Do you also like to sleep long? Schläfst du auch gern lange? It's up to you how you say it. Ich helfe Klaus. Und du? Hilfst du auch Klaus? I help Klaus. And you? Do you also help Klaus? Ich laufe im Park. Und du? Läufst du auch im Park? I walk through the park or in the park. And you? Do you also walk in the park? Ich fahre Fahrrad. Und du? Fährst du auch Fahrrad? I drive my bike or I drive a bike. And you? Do you also drive your bike or a bike? Ich nehme eine Pizza. Und du? Nimmst du auch eine Pizza? Sorry, it should be here. Because I wanted to make clear that you don't have to say the eine if you don't want to. Nimmst du auch Pizza? Do you also take pizza? Both is fine in this case. Ich spreche mit Max. Und du? Sprichst du auch mit Max? I talk to Max or I speak with Max. And you? Do you also speak with Max? I think it's a good timing to learn a special verb that is really important in actually every language. It is sein, to be. Ich bin, du bist, sie ist, or er ist, or es ist, er, sie, es, he, she, it, ist, wir sind, ihr seid, sie sind. The easiest way, of course, is to say A is B, like the examples here. I am student, she's a student, we are students, and so on. And another pattern you have learned, A is and an adjective. I think I gave you this pattern a long time ago in the fashion vocabulary or even before, I'm not sure. But now I give it again to you. Sie ist sehr freundlich. She's very nice. Stuff like that. So you can say A is B. You can also say A is somehow, an adjective describing A. This is how you do it. And of course, they will follow like a bajillion other ways to use it. But step by step. This is it for today. Next time we will continue with to be. And we will learn some other really nice things that will make your skin crawl. Maybe. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, please, and follow us on Los Sprachschule on Instagram. I try to announce every time I post a new video. We do some quizzes. And of course, the more people join, the more content I will create. If you have questions, feedback, please leave it in the comments below or maybe even a like. Thank you so much and I will see you very soon. Bye.